How to play Heal Specter. Your heal skill grants barrier to allies. Shadow steps heal, such as your wells, shortbow 5, scepter 3, sword 2, and more. F1 gives fury, might, and swiftness. F1 also gives vigor and strips 3 boons. When you leave Shroud, you lose all shadow force, but it gets turned into healing and overhealing into barrier. Shadow stepping heals even more, returns shadow force, and wells also grant resistance. Your Shroud skills affect your whole party and you give Alac by using Shroud skills. Note that this happens around your tethered ally. Shroud 1 heals and gives might. Shroud 2 cleanses a condition and heals. Shroud 3 gives a barrier and heals. Shroud 4 heals. Shroud 5 gives stability and heals. Your Shroud skills scale with the number of targets that you hit. So more targets hit means more boons, barrier and heals. Use Will of Bounty for tons of boons. Use Scepter 2 on targets for more might or on allies for protection and barrier. Use Scepter 3 against enemies for pushing power or on allies for regeneration and healing. Use Pistol 4 to CC. We run Herald Runes, which gives 4 seconds of protection when using a heal skill. In summary, you can provide almost every boon in the game except Quickness and Resolution. The general loop is cycling between your Shroud abilities and using your initiative for Scepter 2, 3 or Pistol 4 as needed, while using F1 and your utilities mostly off cooldown. During Shroud, you can for the most part just spam your Shroud 1 and save the other Shroud skills for whenever you need them. Lastly, since you need to target your allies to unleash the full potential of Specter, it is beneficial to use keybindings for targeting. You can set keybinds to call target and for personal target, and to switch between those at the press of a button. Let's have a look into practice. In general, you want to run Scepter and Pistol for the support it provides. For the second set in HTCM, a shortbow is convenient for mobility. Instead of shortbow, Scepter 3 would have been a bit better for pushing. Whenever you're with the group, try to pre-stack Alac. I'm running Shadow Step here as the first utility, but overall, Will of Silence provides better utility. Placing portal here to get back quickly from greens. safety, always give stability during intermissions. Similar to before, Scepter 3 would have been better for pushing. Ideally, for stability against the waves, you would want to use first Shroud 5 to cover the first two waves, and then Well of Bloom to cover the third one. Here I'm again pre-placing the portal to get back quickly from a green later. Make sure to use your CC for all of the intermissions and give stability to your allies. I manually target the player in my party here for protection and barrier with Scepter 2. It would have been better to use a keybinding, of course. Always teleport back to the group with your heal well, which gives barrier protection and resistance. Usually you would use your pre-casted portal to get back to the group now, I just forgot here and didn't use it at all. The cooldown for preparing the portal starts when you actually place it, which means that you could use it again for the next screen, which you can see now because it's ready again. The resistance from wells will always cover the feed duration, however you can still cleanse it and give barrier with Shroud 2 and 3, respectively. Always make sure to immediately cast Siphon to strip boons from enemies such as the dragons and the Timecaster. Before Suwon starts, you can pre-cast your portal again. opening the portal here for the second red to quickly get back to the group. To have your stability ready for this intermission. Make sure to use your stability, since the obliterator still lives and can always charge into the group. Here for the second red, you can use the shadow portal again instead of the shadow step like me here. And again for safety, as soon as it's available, press your stability again. This video is useful in learning Heal Specter. I think it's one of the strongest kites around right now. And thanks for watching.